Conservative Media viewers, what's going on? It's me, John DiValero. Okay, here is another UFO story, or rather, there's sort of more information on an earlier UFO story. So it's kind of a new story, but also an extension of an old story, if you will, in my personal opinion. First of all my personal opinion only. I'm not alleging facts, not casting aspersions. This is all for entertainment and parody purposes only. Please check the disclaimers. Okay, now, we're talking about a possible underwater UFO. Here's the deal. Apparently, there was a Swedish team, I guess some researchers or something, and this was in the Gulf of Bothnia. Now, that's near Finland and Sweden, okay? And they were going along, and their equipment, some of the sonar equipment, now, it doesn't seem to be, in my personal opinion, the most accurate sonar equipment, but apparently this sonar equipment or some of their equipment had picked up a strange object. It was about 300 feet below the surface of the water, right? And, you know, was it round? Did it look like a saucer? What was it? And there seemed to be some drag marks or some kind of, you know, trail, skid marks, whatever you want to call it, behind the object for a little ways. So people seem to be speculating about what this was. There really wasn't any conclusive evidence as to definitively say, was it a rock? Was it some other kind of natural occurrence? Or was it something else? Was it something odd and unusual that was 300 feet below the surface of the water in this gulf up there in Northern Europe? Apparently, there's a new observation, something else down there in the water that isn't really defined either. However, this second observation seems to be a different thing from what we can understand. It doesn't seem to be, you know, have that really round shape or whatnot. It has a different kind of non-symmetrical type of shape, it seems like. So, again, is this something natural? Is there something unusual going on down there under the ocean? Is it just possible that this is an underwater UFO? Here's my personal opinion on this. I do not believe there's a UFO down there. I believe that there's some kind of natural phenomenon that we haven't fully scoped out here. And quite frankly, probably takes some good equipment to go down there and scope it out. And who knows? You might find a rock. You might find, who knows, whatever. There's all kinds of different things. Maybe there's currents that are dragging stuff, you know, just pieces of rock or boulders or any number of sort of natural phenomenon and plausible explanations. And I just think, in my personal opinion, from what I've seen so far, that this is probably some situation where, you know, the equipment was fine for what they were trying to do, but it wasn't at the level that can give us the clarity that we need to know for this. And it was just maybe something that looked like it was stranger than it really is. That's my personal opinion from what we've seen. But again, we don't know. We don't have the final conclusion on this. And that's what makes it interesting to talk about. What do you think about it? What's your take on it? Do you think this is a natural phenomenon? Do you think that there's maybe something possibly unexplained or unusual here? And do you think that we should have a serious expedition with the right equipment to find out exactly what's going on down there? Or do you think that it's just a waste of time? What's your take on it? What's your opinion? Give me the comments below. Please subscribe above. I'm John DiValero, and you're watching Conservative New Media.